Ho, ho, ho! Kumusta kayo lahat? Welcome to the crossover, the basketball show for the Filipino community. My name is PJ under this beard, and this is the holidays, so we're having fun right here in the studio. Marky Mark on my side, looking like an elf over here, and we got JR? JR's back?
I'm back, bro. When? Yay!
Gone for four. We should clap for
come
that.
Come on, sure, man. Okay. I'm sick. Like, I was
You're
dying.
Sick or you were sick?
I was sick.
You
I
were
was
sick. Because he was, no, he was
I'm
gone
not,
for
don't
four
worry, I'm not
Are you
sick
still
anymore.
Sick? Should we like, turn away from
Well,
it?
You have something to cover. I got nothing.
I got my beer.
Don't worry. I didn't drink your coffee this morning.
All right, man. So, wait. First of all, why were you really sick? Why were you gone
I was
for
sick.
That
okay,
long?
So the first two episodes I missed, car broke down.
Okay.
But it wasn't broken. So, well, that's another conversation. Next, the last two episodes, I was really sick. I went down with a fever, coughing a lot, couldn't control my coughing, and I was resting a lot. I missed school a lot.
I'm done school. Stay in school.
Yeah, I'm done school. First semester journalism. We're done, man.
Journalism. No, so you're coming back with some new,
of course,
fresh new ideas.
Of course.
And with that said, let's go straight into the first segment, which is the rundown, basketball-related topics and news. JR, what do we have? Or Mark, what do you have?
I guess some Christmas theme kind of question we can have. I don't know. I like the idea of what do you guys think of some of the Christmas treats that we've gotten so far early in the season? I don't know what you guys are.
But like Like Russell Westbrook's dropping 30 triple doubles everywhere? I mean, that's like he's going to be MVP. I know you guys were talking about the past few episodes when I wasn't here.
Mm-hmm.
He's definitely going to be MVP. At least, and personally, I think he's a lock for MVP.
He's carrying the team. Like at this point, like you can see, even just recently with Victor Oladipo getting injured, like you can see how important he is. Like he didn't even miss a beat that much with Victor Oladipo getting injured because Westbrook just literally just went up another gear in a sense, right? So I mean, there's so much more. I felt like the season so far, like Antetokounmpo's game so
oh, that's
far.
Guy, that's my fantasy. That's my guy on my fantasy. I drafted right. him really early.
It's playing
Giannis
well.
Antetokounmpo is nasty
yeah.
too.
Yeah.
Like they were saying how he's still a beast. He's just a young kid still.
21 years old and he's doing
he has
this.
So much potential. He could just get a rebound, dribble like three dribbles off the court, on the court, and then fast break point.
He can do a euro
it's
step
so easy
from the 3-point line. That's kind of ridiculous how he can do a euro step, two step, euro step from the 3-point line. Right?
He's totally a Greek freak. Yeah. Right? Mark, what would you say is your favorite Christmas treat so far?
To me so far, I think the best treat I've seen so far is just how well the Warriors have shared the basketball. Like it's just been dropping dimes, just giving it to each other. Most of them are just playing hot potato. It's just
yeah.
like, right? Like, the amount of assists they've given every single night, they're averaging about 31 assists a game,
mm-hmm.
right? They've never that's never been done since the Showtime Lakers day with Magic Johnson, right?
And honestly, we have yet to see them really, really dominate with the big three. I say big three.
Well, that's actually got
Kevin
me
Durant.
To, like, you know, another topic too we can go on quickly. Like, now we're coming to the new year. What are you kind of looking for from now, you know, when the new year starts? What kind of things that we're kind of looking for to see from the NBA or teams in general or players?
I mean, I can't wait for that Christmas Day game between the rematch.
Oh, yeah.
Warriors and Cavaliers for the first time this season.
Who are you leaning toward for that one?
Definitely Warriors. I got like
you cannot
because what Cleveland right now? J.R. Smith's injured.
Yeah.
Kevin Love is out right now, so they're gonna have Kyrie Irving and LeBron James still carry their backs. What they done in the last series in the finals?
Mm-hmm.
But right now they're putting too much pressure on them right now early in the season, especially with J.R. Smith and Kevin Love out. I mean they do have backups like Liggins, Tristan Thompson. They're still doing well.
Mm-hmm.
I mean all that pressure on them getting that effort early in the season is like it might have something to do with them later on.
Mm-hmm. Why is J.R. Smith out again?
Injured his thumb. Oh, he's gonna have thumb. A surgery.
But I feel like at
he's
this
gonna
point,
have surgery.
At
so.
This point, the Cavs kind of understand. Like, they basically have the same team that they had when they won the championship. They kind of understand how the season goes through. They're not as concerned as any other teams right now, like as the Warriors could be, or in terms of figuring out their offense, figuring out how all their players can mesh and actually get back on track and actually play at that elite level. Because now the Cavs kind of figure out already what they are, what they do. They have the same personnel.
Mm-hmm.
So for them, they're just cruising into the play, you know, if they already came back from a 3-1 lead, being 3-1 mm-hmm. down, they know what they're capable of. So for them, I don't think they're not as worried. with the matchup for the Christmas, or with them kind of having these injuries, because they know they're going to make the playoffs and they know that they're capable.
It's not like a statement game. They're just going to Cleveland right now and on Christmas Day, play a day game, and they're probably not going to have that much people on their roster. Like, they're not fully healthy. So, I mean, that could be probably, like, you know, what they would say, an excuse, saying if the Warriors do win, they didn't have that much, like, talent on the team. So, I mean, it's just one game, but I'm still excited for the game. It's going to be a high-scoring game. Mm-hmm. Most likely, there probably could be a drama, which we usually like.
Shout out to LeBron passing, too. What's his name on the all-time scoring list, too? Malone.
Malone.
He passed it just recently.
The youngest to ever do
Shout out to that king right there.